Audio Jump. Audio Jump. Audio Jump.
Pictured all together for the first time, this is the world record breaking 9 miracle babies born to the same mother as the healthy brood prepare to go home. Halima sees beams proudly with her nonuplets, 5 months after she made headlines around the globe when she gave birth at the Ayn Borja Clinic in Casablanca, Morocco, breaking the previous world record set by Octomom Nadia Suleiman in 2009, who gave birth to 8 babies that survived. Speaking exclusively to Mail Online, Miss Sis, 26, said, "All of them are getting on very well, and are a joy to look after. They are getting stronger every day, and it may well be they are allowed to leave full-time medical care soon, so that we can take them home." Ems Sis's 9 tots, who were conceived naturally, each weighed between 500 g to 1 kg when they were born and had to remain in incubators in the clinic's intensive care unit where they were looked after round the clock by a team of doctors and nurses for the first few months of their lives. But now all 9 have gained weight and continued to thrive, meaning they can soon go back to their home country, Mali. As the babies approach 6 months, Miss Sis and her partner Kader Arbi, 35, celebrated by releasing TC touching new photographs showing them together as a group. The new pictures show the boys, Omar, Eladji, Ba and Mohamed VI, in green romper suits bearing the word brother on them. The girls, Adama, Omo, Hawa, Khadidia, and Fatoma, meanwhile wear a mixture of pink and baby blue outfits. All the Arbi tots are Malian nationals, and they were last week visited by Yaminatou Sangare, the country's health minister, who worked out how they could be safely flown to Bamako, the Malian capital, which is some 2,500 miles from Casablanca. They were taken off incubators in early August since when the family have been living together in flat close to the hospital so the medical staff can continue to monitor them. We revealed in Juli how Halima was getting through a staggering 100 nappies per day and 6 liters of milk, but that she was too tired to look after them and spent most of her day sleeping and watching television. But now her strength is returning too. Giving birth to one child is hard enough, but having 9 is unimaginable, said Halima. It's astonishing the amount of work that is involved in looking after them. I'm grateful to the medical team that are doing all the hard work and the government of Mali for funding this. Halima gave birth by cesarean section, accompanied by her sister, Aisha, while her husband initially stayed behind at their home in Timbuktu, Mali. Describing the birth, Halima said, "As the babies were coming out, there were so many questions going through my mind. I was very aware of what was going on and it seemed as if there was an endless stream of babies coming out of me." She added, "My sister was holding my hand, but all I could think about was how would I look after them and who was going to help me." Kader was originally unable to travel due to COVID travel restrictions, but finally arrived in Morocco on July 9, after spending 10 days in quarantine. The care bill so far is approaching the equivalent of una libra million, and most it has been picked up by the Malian government. She almost died from blood loss during the delivery, with doctors estimating that her belly alone weighed almost 30 kilograms, made up of the babies and amniotic fluid. He said, "Born together as a family is the best thing in the world, and we give thanks to God all the time. The most important thing is that we are all safe and well, and in great hands." The couple married in 2017 and also have another daughter, Souda, 2.5, who is being looked after by relatives. Kader is a sailor in the Malian Navy and admitted that looking after his family would be financially challenging. They live in a modest 3-bedroom house which he said they would now have to expand to accommodate their 10 children. "There is plenty of us to worry about, but we are mainly full of positive thoughts," said Kader, "and we are primarily focused on looking after our babies and getting them home. At the moment we have full-time care, and that's a blessing because my wife needs the rest." Kader and Halima also feel blessed as they have been receiving tons of messages of support from well-wishers from around the world who post heartwarming comments online. The couple were originally told that Halima was carrying 7 babies by doctors in Mali, who feared that there was a less than 50% chance that any of them would survive. She spent 2 weeks in Point G Hospital in Bamako, Mali's capital, before she was transferred to Morocco thanks to the intervention of Mali's then president of transition, Ba Endao. This is why one of the boys is called Ba. Another is named Mohamed B, in honor of the King of Morocco. Kader, who is a devout Muslim, said, "My wife is an only child while I have 8 brothers and sisters. There is nothing in our family history to explain how this happened other than Ayach's grace. These children are a gift from him. In accordance with Islamic custom, the names of the newborns were revealed 7 days after their birth. The babies were born in the following order: Khadidia, 2 kg 840, Mohammed VI, 3 kg 315, Fatoma, 3 kg 130, Omar, 2 kg 400, Hawa, 1 kg 585, Adama, 2 kg 720, Ba, 2 kg 900, Omo, 2 kg 795, Andelad G, 1 kg 870.